So we are going to have how can have time dependence of wave function psi. So this is the thing we are going to have in this class because we have both time independent Schrodinger equation as well as time dependent Schrodinger equation. In one of the cases, the psi is operated upon by energy operator. So we are going to see the subtleties which will come out how time enters into the whole picture of this quantum mechanics. So time dependence of the psi. So psi as a function, it has a dependence on every time. So it has a value, psi values at time t naught as a function of t. And in within situations, we can have time explicit, which is the second Schrodinger equation. First one was time independent, and the second was the time dependent. So what we can say is that if psi depends upon time, then what we can do is we can use ordinates of t in the right hand form of the expansion. Right-hand form of the expansion means that we can do it either two ways. We can have phi, if you remember, and sigma dependence. If you see, we had phi sine in terms of, we also wrote psi in terms of sigma i phi. And if it's combined for both phi and sigma. So we can have, for example, simplest case of time as dependence of psi as a specific function can be written as psi of t is phi of eigenvalue h beyond s. So it depends upon eigenvalue So use two. So here we have a site whose dependence is both on standard algorithm as well as exclusive terms of time. So we are going to use this definition of site here. Yes. So this equation, h of operator psi can be written as so if it's derivative of psi of pt, psi of pt, so derivative of, so h will come outside, so it will be h d psi d prime. So we have this equation, we have written this equation as we have written this equation which combines both these two ideas. So we have psi as well as and this h, so the Hamiltonian, which is dependence on energy, and so both are attractive. So here the h operator, operating on this energy operator, will do like this. So we can say that h, so from this we can say that h operator operating on phi of t is equal to h t phi of t. That's it. H operator y of t is equal to h of t y of t. To find this like psi of t. So before, so we see as before the time independent factor, time independent factor. Is determined by first Schrödinger Now we can also have stationary cases, so stationary cases are the, you can say they are the stable states as compared to the regulatory states, which may be intermediate states or transitive states. So how can the evolution of psi, which will enable us to represent those states which can be stationary also and which can be transitive also. The transition state depends upon the difference of energy eigenvalues between two subsequent states. So the Schrödinger equation is constructed. It's constructed. The second Schrödinger equation is constructed. Second Schrödinger equation is constructed. So the second Schrödinger equation is constructed. It follows the second Schrödinger equation is constructed. Principle of superposition. So it's like a state psi is basically superposition of many states psi, and so what out of those superposition of those states, what can constitute as stationary states and what are those transitive states which may be traditionally correspond to Bohr's stationary states. electron moves the body and pull energy at has a sharp value h t. What?
Rather than in the classical sense, any eigenvalue or any h, any Hamilton, any.
You see, we can have, we should have a sharp h t,
which will cause from those states, which are those states.
So what we can achieve this by the right hand side of Q of T, Ganymede as sigma T psi K Q of T. So each sigma K can be independent of T, and psi K has a mean equation. Psi K has a mean. So psi k represents both. So here we can have this interval of time, this is interval of time, but here it has something.
So if you the constructs of different frequencies or in the bundle of these wave functions which will correspond to a different frequencies
which are given in this equation, equation 5. So we can have a sigma t point, 10 sigma t equal minus twice pi over HP in the
again, we are going to do sub T. So psi K can be written as psi Q T can be written as sigma K prime. So we reduce here sigma K prime. Pi of Q. So we have psi. So sigma k can be written as sigma k or psi of k can be written as psi of k can be written as yes. So it's sigma k line. So we have written this two different things. We can put this vis-a-vis this.
So why we are doing these substitutions is that we have to have the dependence, explicit dependence of psi,
explicit implicit dependence of psi on time as a solution of Schrodinger equation.
This double interpretation is possible because time enters only in the form of exponential factor, which can be either included as a quotient of the in the quotient or in the eigenfunction. In the quotient or in the eigenfunction, as this explicit dependence of time. That's it. Now the point is
so if we have a complex conjugate of it, so if it's k, you can have sigma k prime, so it will be the complex conjugate of it. So if it's 1, so it will be minus, it will turn out to be plus iota k and you can say t. So if you multiply the two, psi sigma k square, so if you have, you can have a psi star, so you can have sigma t, so it will be star, so you can have this as a function of q power twice pi over h k minus h m by t. So you can see size in terms of sigma t square will be psi in terms of this will be psi to the square into sigma square. So you can see you have you multiply this with this. You keep this from this you can have the intermediate states also. So psi evolution of psi it will not only include those states but also intermediate states or transitive states which will normally move at radiation is evolved as a difference of two energy ion states between the thing. And in the known previous old model. So from 7, which is 7, you can see second Schrodinger equation. And write them in terms of write them like this. So I would have H these I would have H for the is for the sigma I. I would have H for the point B sigma 2 by B 5 K. And H operator operating on psi, this is energy operator operating on psi. So this is equal to sigma k H operator operating on 5k. Or this is equal to sigma prime H k 5. You can have one of the Schrodinger equations, this is time dependent Schrodinger equation, you can write in terms of this sigma by k and this. So in terms of energy eigen states, so H operator operating on psi is equal to H psi is equal to E psi. And E psi is an energy operator. You can have this. The second line is the first one. The second line is the first one. That way, so let it be that way. So if you want to write it like this, and operator at one side is basically this. So according to one, port 1, fishing 1, fishing 1. 1 is the edge of the on side, 2 is at the edge point, 2 point liberty of side 2. According to 1, you can say that you can have, so this is edge operator here, this is edge operator here. The exponent shows this is equal to this. Of energy is time dependent. So wherever you have a disconnected state, so it has a sigma, sigma is dependent upon sigma has a psi dependence. So psi is dependent upon sigma this thing. So wherever you have energy this undergoing or energy operator, so you can have it's explicit dependence on time. There's a time. So probability distribution function psi has a time dependence. The time dependence wherever energy is provided. So it's one of the inference you can get out of this concept, understanding. So if we, for example, now the question is, if we expand psi to b, if we expand psi to b, as energy eigenfunctions of time. So, of any other entity B which is not commutative, with energy, we have. So we have psi as a function of chi, which is not commutative. Then the expansion quotient this does not have a special form. Like that of 6, does not necessarily have this special form. So if this is not commutative, it should not have a special form like this. Then we would have defined sigma. And there is an explicit dependence of sigma on the time interval. And sigma is an inside. Two sides are related. So you, if it's not commutative, so you need not have an explicit dependence of this sigma. Sigma is basically related to psi. Here we have both constructions of time dependence and time independence of psi in the word here. So if this is not commutative, it's not necessarily the function we have this for. This is what we can say. On investigation case, this is psi is given by the function of energy. So it will only work for stationary states where eigen functions will be given certain energies. This means that in the part of the states will be some sort of constant. It will follow from the expansion of the equation 2. Equation 2. Equation 2 is sine 2 of t is going to 5 root 2 of e to the minus 2 by 2 by h to t by x. If it has an explicit dependence on this thing, if you find it in this way, then what I can say from this expansion, if you find things like this, so this this thing can be written as psi of E can be written as 2 pi over this H sigma tau pi. Or tau n can be written as 2 pi over h by e by n h by n. In both cases, scalar coefficients are time independent. Square of the coefficients are time independent. What does it all mean? It means that if I use the same thing, so we have what we have constructed both dependence of sine on explicit and implicit dependence of time, such that we construct both stationary states as well as other transitive states. And the question is, we arrived at the Heisenberg. Wherever we had an energy operator, it should the psi should have been dependent on time. So can we construct a psi which will not necessarily be arrived at what this function, which has both explicit and implicit definition of time. So if you do that way for the stationary states, this will come out to be so if it's like that, so this entire thing, if you want to write it in terms of words, we can say that state function, psi is always time dependent. Psi has a power of E. So it's dependence on time, it's dependence on time. And is controlled by Schrodinger equation. In the stationary case, psi 2 t, so in station 2, psi 2 t consists of time dependence for it. Here the phi 2 is an explicit dependence of energy operator, which is the eigen function of energy. So the probability difference is in non-stationary part, psi 2 t can be expanded into the energy from eigen functions which are non-commutative of energy, And the quotient will contain for the 4 of 6, the coefficient will be of the 4 of 6.
So you can have you can include both stationary as well as non-stationary aspects of eigen functions in case of energy states, eigen states which have a time dependence. If it's commutative and if it's non-commutative, we can arrive at non-stationary states. Yes. So this was the thing. And sine 2, this sine 2, and this they can be determined with each other. So we have defined sine is a beside but through the sigma. And sigma we have defined as we have introduced Hamilton time this dependence here. So here sigma is subordinate with the sine indirectly. Here we incorporate the definition of time. And the more important thing is how we can arrive at stationary as well as non-stationary states by this explicit construction.